catch up on where we last left off. At last.
Terra, Aqua, and Ventus entered into a grueling final battle. As they fought, Xehanort summoned Kingdom Hearts. Terra's body became a vessel for Xehanort, but his lingering will and devotion to Aqua and Ventus remained attached to his armor. Even knowing that his own heart would be destroyed in the process, Ventus fought to stop the Keyblade from forming. As Ventus struggled, Aqua confronted Vanitas, who had taken control of Ventus's body. Drawing strength from her friends, she destroyed the Keyblade.
Yep, that's what happened. Alright. Yeah, that guy straight up looked like a bad guy right off the bat. Alright, now we go to the world tour. Here we go. Kingdom Hearts, Birth by Sleep. Mess that up.
It's over.
Oh well. Yay. A new field battle song is now available to play. Oh, I'm proud. That's not gonna happen right now. Here we go.
Ventus's heart fell into a deep sleep. Aqua faced off against Terra, whose body was controlled by Master Xehanort. To restore his heart to him, Aqua fought with all she had. Xehanort drove Terra's heart out of his body. Terra fell to darkness. Refusing to lose her friend, Aqua sent him back to the Realm of Light, but he awoke with no memories and called himself Xehanort.
Mm-hmm.
Trapped in the realm of darkness and all alone, Aqua was about to give up the endless battle with darkness when her connections to her friends appeared in the form of a brilliant light and saved her. Sora, still just a child, had previously joined his heart with Ventus's. The connection they shared brought Ventus's wounded heart back to him.
Cool. Cleared. Ooh. Three new worlds. Or that must be the, yeah. Birth by sleep afterwards. Okay. And this is dream drop distance. But this one, what's this? What is this? Come on, come on. Writhing melody. Melody? I feel like that might be spoilers. Kingdom Hearts Point 2, a fragmentary passage. Okay, yep. Back. We'll wait. Dream drop distance. Yay. Here with 45 HP or more without items. Oh, well, whatever.
Master Yen Sid knew that Sora and Riku still had a lot to learn before they could stop Master Xehanort, so he prompted them to take the Mark of Mastery exam. The exam required the two to dive into sleeping worlds and reawaken them by unlocking their keyholes. But an unfortunate encounter caused Sora and Riku to be flung into different worlds. Fighting alongside benevolent dream eaters, or spirits, they carried on. Suddenly, a boy in a black coat appeared.
Singing and dancing is so embarrassing, huh, Anster? Okay. What? Aster is making a TikTok OnlyFans? That should be fun. Without items, defeat 60% or more. Okay. You showed Aster one of your dance videos. Oh, Aster, did you like it? Stand and talk to people. Okay. Rico, thank you for the daily tax. How's your day going? They're fun emotes, aren't they? Full chain, yay! The one that I like the most is this emote, which I also turned into this, because it just took forever to make. You're chilling? It's okay. No reason to be sorry for slow answers. There we go. Gonna lurk, you have a work meeting. Okay, Misa. Thank you for the lurk. Alright, so that stage will be a grind. Oh, how ironic. Defeat 60 or more aerial enemies. Oh, Penguin. Well, come on in. Thank you. does, Alex, you should have it at like mid-October. I feel like a lot of people would be available then. How many do I have? 8. Okay. Yep. Catchy beat. Next month, 14th or 28th. That works perfect, Alex. Quiet, Penguin. Dang it. Well, that would make sense that you would. Gotcha. I'm always down for karaoke, except for the times when I'm not. Full chain. Woohoo! I'm getting better. And that unlocks Birth by Sleep Fragmentary Passage Part 2, I guess. Cool.